Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series 1 Network Engineers. This is the fourth video on how to initiate SSH connection from GEM host using Python. In the previous video, we have seen how to use a Linux machine as GEM host. The left side script is which we have written. Let me just run and show you. So it is trying to connect to the GEM host. This is a prompt of Linux machine. It is connected to that, and after that it is executing SSH command to Cisco router, and once the connection is successful, executing commands on Cisco router and printing it. Here in the right side, instead of Linux, I am using a Cisco router itself as GEM host. You can see the device IP 0.49 and remaining logics are same here, and device type is Cisco IOS. Only one thing which you need to be careful is this delay. In some devices, what I have noticed is it takes more than 10 seconds to get the password prompt. For example, here I already has initiated SSH to 49. From here, ssh-l admin 192.168.0.50. If I give this command, it takes around 10 seconds to get this password prompt. At that time, if you give lesser time, script will never come here because output will not be having the password prompt, and it will directly go here. So you should be careful about that. You need to validate whether that the delay what you give is sufficient to get the password prompt. So here, for safety, what I have done is I'm just printing additional message. After getting password prompt, I'm just printing received password prompt. Other than that, script logic is same, and here to make this script simple, I hard coded the password, but it is always better to use SSH key for initiating connection and executing the commands. I have created another video explaining SSH key, and wherever you use automation, it is better to use SSH key. Now let us try running this script. You can see the prompt, it is CSR49, and we have received password prompt, and destination device prompt is CSR50, and executing the command. And here, since this source and destination device types are same, even if you don't do the redispatch, it should work. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.